It's in a coastal corner of the missile complex that the new military shuttle launching center is positioned. Built with the benefit of the Kennedy Space Center's hindsight, this is a far more compact facility than the sprawling Florida complex. Some of the more sensitive military space equipment is already arriving here. Contracts have just been awarded for the initial Star Wars defense research here. Shuttle launches are seen as a crucial element in the attempt to build President Reagan's idea of an anti-missile shield in space. But long before the military shuttle gets into space, there have been problems to cure on the ground. The landscaping of 10 miles of Californian Interstate Highway has been re-sculptured to enable the shuttle to travel from its landing ground to its launch pad. The key reason for putting the launch facility here on the California coast is that for the first time, the military will be able to put their shuttles into a polar orbit. From such an orbit, it's possible to see much more of the Earth's landmasses than from the east-west orbit that's used at Kennedy. Unless the Russians and the Americans in Geneva next month manage to find an agreement to ban the militarization of space, then this will become, within the next 5 years, the center of America's thrust to put the so-called Star Wars concept of defense into space.